Pablo is one of the truly great pioneers in biotechnology.
Ed Penhode is an icon in the biotechnology business.
We started Chiron in 1981. The most important thing in our minds was the extraordinary opportunity we had to do something practical with the science that we've been working on.
We acted as a trio for those 20, 25 years. Ed would focus on organizational matters and presentation of the company to the outside, and Pablo would work on R&D.
Chiron developed a significant number of products that have had major impact in human health.
For the first time ever, the Food and Drug Administration has approved for human use a vaccine produced through gene splicing.
We have few and few companies making vaccines, and now comes a new technology that can make vaccines very easily, very effective.
The hepatitis B vaccine was the first recombinant DNA vaccine.
I consider the hepatitis B virus vaccine one of the major advances in preventive medicine of the 20th century.
It then led to the discovery of hepatitis C. And this wasn't just turning the crank, this was identifying a new virus and applying technology to it so that you could now diagnose it and subsequently treat it.
In 1976, about a quarter of the people that had blood transfusions got a hepatitis from them. Now today, it's 1 in 10 million.
Chiron's blood testing division developed these viral load tests for hepatitis C, hepatitis B, as well as HIV, that forever enabled a safe worldwide blood supply.
I think the products that have had most impact are the ones that are related to the safety of the blood supply. There's a before and after in the blood banks.
Ed and Pablo, both at Chiron, as well as in the endeavors they've taken after Chiron, have done so much to make the world a better place.
What I admire most about Pablo is that he actually went back to his country and tried to see, how can I help the people there?
He founded a non-profit organization, Fundación Ciencia de la Vida.
He has a tremendous impact on the science in Chile, the development of new ideas and new things at all levels, university levels, and also at the private enterprise level.
Pablo allowed Medivation to have a lab space in his foundation, and so we actually did a lot of work at the Fundación, which has been very important in our developing our pipeline of drugs that we have today.
Salmon fish farming is very big in Chile, but it was being wiped out by a pathogen that was killing the fish. So he developed a vaccine down there in Chile, which was so successful, it was actually acquired by Novartis.
They developed ways of growing bacteria that can leach copper out of the soil, which previously required very many toxic chemicals.
Ed Penhode was really the perfect president for Chiron. He is an astute scientist. He's also a very smart businessman. In addition, he's an outstanding communicator.
In 98, when I left Chiron, the job of dean of the public health school became available at Berkeley.
One of the things he's done for Berkeley is to elevate the role of public health in the biological and life sciences. So the School of Public Health is now very much an integral part of the entire campus.
Ed is a citizen of the world. He has tackled problems that are of very large scale, very important, particularly in the medical field. I think there are a few that have made more contributions than he has. He was an important participant in the development of the Gordon and Betty Moore Foundation.
He wants to make a difference in improving healthcare for people, for advancing technologies.
Ed was also the driving force in the implementation of the California Stem Cell Initiative. Both Pablo and Ed invested in biotechnology through venture capital or their own funds to help start companies from scratch.
There is a great satisfaction by doing well, by doing good. And, for all of us who are in biotech, I think that we're very fortunate to be able to do that.